One key warning sign for a cult is that they use character assassination to manipulate people. Do you use character assassination in order to force or coerce people into accepting your teachings?
Well, to me, character assassination is an unloving thing. So why would I ever do an unloving thing when I'm trying to promote love, right? So no, I don't use character assassination in order to force or manipulate or coerce people. In fact, I don't try to force or manipulate or coerce anybody ever using any technique, yeah. Let alone using an unloving technique. I don't even try to use a loving technique. I don't try to give them a carrot or a stick.
Yeah.
In order to help them become more loving. I just talk to them about the principles of love, and hopefully through their own desire, they decide that they're going to become more loving in their day-to-day life. That's what I would love to see occur. Of course, that is not what always occurs, but that's what I would love to see happen. So all I'm trying to do is encourage a person to utilize their own desire and develop their own desire to become more loving themselves. And force is not a way to make a person become more loving. I know that. I'm not stupid.
Yeah.
Now, I do see, again, many religions and many other organisations on this planet using force as a way of coercing or manipulating people. You know, we see this happening in every religious faith, generally, and particularly in the religious faiths that are what you would classify as fundamental.
Yeah.
So you see in fundamental religious faiths, of which you can classify many Muslim faiths or strains of the Muslim religion,
yeah,
and many Christian strains of religion are very much engaged in coercion and manipulation of others. And my suggestion to people is get out of it. You know, don't any longer put up with that, because that is out of harmony with the use of your will, and it's also out of harmony with love.
Yeah.
It's out of harmony with, you know, desire. And do you think that God is going to approve of you when you do something that you were forced to do in the first place? I doubt it. God's going to approve of you when you decide to do something that's loving through the exercise of your own will, not through somebody trying to force or manipulate or coerce you to do it.
So really you're talking about a difference in motivation when someone's character assassinated or coerced or forced. The motivation for change would be guilt or fear, whereas you are talking about engendering in people or
encouraging
in people a motivation of love. Is that
To develop a desire to be motivated by love even.
Yep.
What I find today is that most people don't even have a desire to be motivated by love, and what I'm attempting to do is encourage people through telling them the truth to have a desire to be motivated by love. What I'm telling them is that there is rewards for living a loving life, and there are also there's pain and suffering that comes from living an unloving life, and we need to learn how to live a loving life if we're ever going to see pain and suffering disappear from the earth. And so what I'm trying to do is encourage people to develop a desire to live a loving life.
Yeah.
Now, you don't do that by manipulating them, and you don't do it by coercing them. You don't do it by the carrot or the stick.
Yeah.
And to me, character assassination is just a stick that other people use. You know, I notice a lot of people use it. I don't do that. However, if a person comes to me and says, like, why do you feel, you know, I feel this way towards that person? I'll say to them, well, that's because you've got this very dark emotion inside of you that says, I want to harm that person.
Yeah.
And I don't call that character assassination. I call that just a presentation of the truth of what's in the person to the person.
So could you contrast that? Contrast the presentation of truth about what's truly in a person's soul condition with what character assassination is.
Well, character assassination does not care what's in the soul of the person.
Mm-hmm.
What it does is it basically attempts to assassinate the character of the individual without actually knowing what's inside the person. Every person who ever speaks to me does at some point recognize that they do have the motivation that I'm talking to them about. I don't judge their motivation. And I also continue to love them even though they have that motivation.
Yeah.
I don't treat them badly because of the motivation. I don't try to pull them down or tell them how bad they are because of the motivation.
Mm-hmm.
But I do attempt to tell them the truth about their motivation. So there are people, and there are literally millions, billions, in fact, of people who are motivated by poor motivations. I agree. And if somebody comes to me and asks the question, do you feel I'm motivated by poor motivation? And if I do feel they are, then I'll say, yes, I feel you are. Here is the poor motivation that I have observed.
Yeah.
But it will only be something that I've observed or can feel within them. And I certainly wouldn't attempt to then pull them down as a result of that poor motivation. I'm just telling them what they've asked me. So, and as everybody knows, who knows me knows, I only tell people who ask me or people who force themselves upon me anything about their nature or character, depending upon what happens in our interactions.
Mm-hmm.
So if a person comes up and says, look, do you feel I have a, you know, motivation in this? I'll be honest with what my feelings are. They've asked me for my feelings, and it would be dishonest of me, in fact, to share them.
To share them
in a lying fashion, to lie to them, it'd be dishonest of me. Or to withdraw from sharing with them at all would also be not giving them what they asked for.
Yeah.
And I don't do those particular things. I try to give people what they ask for if it's in harmony with the laws of love and I'm not feeding their addictions. And I also attempt to let people know the truth whenever I feel I do know it.
Mm-hmm.
And it doesn't mean that I always do even know it. But people will find that most of the time, if they ask me about their personal condition, I will tell them the truth, and later on in their life they will find out that I was probably right about their personal condition, not because I'm right about everything, but rather because I can feel their condition.
Yeah.
Now, that's different to me than character assassination. Character assassination is a purposeful attempt to destroy a person's character, and I've had that happen to me very frequently, where people, particularly in the media or in religious faiths and so forth, have attempted to destroy my character without knowing me at all, mm-hmm. without caring about me at all, without caring about my underlying motivations at all, without caring about whether they were even truthful or not.
Yeah.
And that is character assassination. So what I find happens to me frequently at the hands of other people is character assassination. But what I do with other people is certainly not that.
Yeah.
What I do with people is answer honestly their questions mm-hmm. if they ask them
yeah.
or if they have a personal interaction with me, which I am forced to engage through their force,
yeah.
I will also answer them.
Yeah. Okay, great.